हेलो एंड वेलकम टू द फिफ्थ पार्ट, द फिफ्थ पार्ट ऑफ सितंबर कोर्ट शेफ लॉन्ग. लेट अस लुक एट द प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट. देर आर टू पाइल्स ऑफ कार्ड. वन पाइल बिलोंग्स टू शेफ एंड अदर बिलोंग्स टू शेफू. वन पाइल मे बी एम्प्टी एट एनी मोमेंट. ईच कार्ड यूज्ड इन द गेम हैज अ पॉजिटिव इंटीजर वैल्यू. Whenever the value of the card becomes non-positive, that is, it becomes zero or less, that is, less than or equal to zero, it is removed from the game. The game is played in rounds. In each round, each player simultaneously draws one card from the top of the pile. If one player's pile is empty, this player cannot draw a card and therefore loses the game. So, if anybody becomes empty, this is our first observation. Empty is equal to lose. Okay. Next observation. If values of the drawn cards are equal, each player simply places the card he drew to the bottom of the pile. Okay. Fair enough. Otherwise, the player whose card has higher value wins this round. Okay. So, in other words, if I drew 3 and you drew 2, I win the round. And what happens when I win the round? What happens is that my 3 will go to the bottom of the pile. Okay. The card he drew to the bottom of the pile. I'll clear things up. So my card will go to the bottom of the pile. And then the card his opponent drew is transferred to him. And he places this card to the bottom of the pile. So if I had 3, you had 2, I win the round. I win. Your 2 comes to me. So this is my pile. At the bottom of the pile, I have my 3. And then below that, I will place your 2. But before I place your 2, whenever a card is transferred from one player to other, the value of that card decreases by 1. So this becomes 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. Okay. So this is what happens. When there is no transfer of card between players during, this is infinity. Seriously, this is infinity. Infinite consecutive rounds. Each player calculates the sum of values of the cards that are currently in his pile. If one player has a higher sum, the player wins the game. Otherwise, the game ends in a draw. So now we are supposed to, I did not paste it here because of space constraints, but we are supposed to calculate the number of instances where there is a result to the game, where somebody wins. If it's a draw, it shouldn't be counted. So the number of cases, that is what the problem is asking us. Number of cases where there is a result. Let us do a simulation and things will be very clear after that. Okay. So the first person starts with this pile of cards 2, 2, 1, 4. The second guy starts with 3, 2, 2, 3. An order doesn't matter. 3, 2, 2, 2. The order doesn't matter. You will see why in a moment. What happens after the first round? This guy wins. Second guy wins. Correct? Second guy wins because 3 is greater than 3 is greater than 2. So second guy wins. What happens after that? So 3 goes to the bottom of the pile and this 2 gets transferred and it becomes a 1. Okay. So let's continue the game. 2 and 2 draw. So this 2 goes to the bottom of the pile and this 2 also goes to the bottom of the pile. So that's what happened. What about this round? Again the second guy wins. So looks like the second guy is winning clearly, right? Let's see. So 2 and 1, what happens? 2 goes to the bottom of the pile and 1 becomes 0. So 1 is not transferred. It's deleted from the game. So now the first guy has just 2 cards, 4 and 2. The second guy has 2, 3, 1, 2, 2. The first guy, second guy so far not lost any card. But this 4 is able to trump this 2 because this 4 is larger than 2. Correct? 4 is greater than 2. So who wins this round? The first guy wins this round. So 4 goes to the bottom of the pile and then this 2 gets transferred as 1. This 2 becomes a 1 and gets transferred. Okay, let's continue. So if you observe, I am not going to walk through all the details. So what happens is whenever it is 4's turn, it crushes the opponent. And eventually, whoever has the larger card will win. Okay, and that is why chef and trump cards. Trump cards. Trump. Why trump? Why are we using the word trump? Notice 4 is greater than every other card. So 4 is the trump card. 4 will trump everything and eventually the first guy will win. Okay? So let's formally make some observations. I'll make 3 observations before going on to the implementation. The first observation is that if there is only one instance of the max card, there will always be a winner. Why? If there is only one max card, let's call the max card 12. Whoever has 12, if chef has 12, chef wins. If chefu has 12, chefu wins. So in other words, if there is one card, whoever has it will win. If there is one nuclear weapon, whoever has it will win. Correct? If there are odd instances of the max card, one player will always have more max cards than the other. Hence, there will always be a winner. Why? Notice this constraint. When there is no transfer of cards between players during 10 power 100 consecutive rounds, each player calculates the sum of the value of the cards that are currently in this pile. So what will happen? Let us say I start with just 2 cards, 12 and 12. And you start with 12, 6, 5, 8, 9, 10, blah, 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 blah. But my 12 and 12 will trump everything of yours. Eventually, I'll have 12 and 12, you'll have a single 12. So my total will be 24, your total will be 12. So I win, you lose. Correct? So in other words, whenever there are odd instances, so in this case, there were odd instances. 12, 1, number 2, number 3. Whenever there are odd instances of the max card, one player will always win. Make sense? So this is a generalized, second observation is a generalization of first. If there is one instance, there will be a winner. Similarly, if there is odd instance, there will be a winner. So in this case, there will be 2 power n distributions where you can have a winner because each card can be distributed to either player. Similarly, in this case also. Now, let's look at the third case, the tricky case. If there are even instances of the max card, whenever the max card is evenly distributed, there won't be a winner. What does that mean? Let us say there are 6, 12, and these 12 are the trump cards. I get 3, you get 3. What happens? Our cards trump each other's cards and eventually we'll have 3 12s, 12, 12 and 12. Because every time there is a transfer, remember, we lose 1 point. So eventually all the cards will be destroyed other than the trump cards because we are playing infinity is equal to 10 power 100 rounds. So everything gets destroyed. So now 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12. My sum is 36, your sum is 36. So there is no winner. So in other words, when there are even instances, this is the only instance where we need to do some thinking. So when there are even instances, when the max card is evenly distributed, then there won't be a winner. When there is an odd distribution, there will be a winner. When there's an even distribution. So suppose I have 12, 12, 12 and 12. You have 12 and 12. So this is what I understand as an uneven distribution. So in this case, I'll win because I have 48 points and you have 24 points. Correct? So when there is an even instance and the cards are evenly distributed, then there won't be a winner. Having said that, let us look at the implementation now. So having made these observations, let us draw a few conclusions. Okay. So like we said, if there are odd instances of maxima card, we have absolute freedom. Any distribution will have a solution. Does that make sense? If there are odd instances of max card, one player will always have more cards. I beg your pardon, more max cards. So there will always be a winner. So how many ways can we distribute that? Let us say we have n cards. For simplicity's sake, let us say we have 4 cards. And we have 2 players, player 1, player 2. Then we have 4 cards, 1, 2, 3, 4. The 4th card can be distributed in 2 ways. It can be either given to this guy or this guy. That can be done in 2 ways. Similarly, the third card can also go to both players in 2 ways. I give the third card to the first person or the second person. So that's 2 more ways. Similarly, the second and first card can also be distributed in 2 and 2 ways respectively. That is 2 to the power 4 ways. So if you have n cards, we can distribute them in 2 power n ways if it is odd instances. Okay, bear that in mind. Okay, what if there are even instances? Even instances, let us say k instances, let us say there are 24 total cards. Out of that, we have 8 cards that are all max. Okay, what does our theory state? The theory states that when there are even instances of max card, when there is even distribution, there won't be a winner. What that means is that if the 8 cards are uniformly distributed, that is 4 cards to player 1, 4 cards to player 2, this means in this case there will be no result, there will be tie. Okay, so let's figure out how many ways we can do that. Step 1, we have to distribute the k cards evenly. How can we distribute the k cards evenly? This is the pool of player A, this is player B. We have to distribute evenly and we have k cards. Okay, so let us call k 8. So we have 8 cards. So what do we need to do? We have to give this guy 4 cards, all of them being maximum. Then this guy will automatically receive the other 4 cards. We have no choice there. In how many ways can we select 4 cards out of 8 cards to give to this guy? That is correct. The answer is 8 choose 4. In other words, if we have k cards, all max k cards, in how many ways can we distribute them? K choose k over 2. These are the number of ways in which we can distribute the maximum number of cards evenly. Okay, but having distributed the max cards, we also need to distribute the non-max cards. So in other words, if there are 24 cards, 8 max cards implies 8 choose 4 ways. What about the other 16 cards? The other 16 cards can be arbitrarily distributed, exactly like this problem. So the other 16 cards can be distributed in 2 power 16 ways. The other n minus k cards, so in other words, if there are n cards, k max and n minus k cards need to be distributed in k choose k over 2 ways, correct? N minus k cards can be distributed in 2 power n minus k ways. Does that make sense? In all these cases, we'll have no result. What are the cases where we'll have result? What are the total number of cases? We already saw that 2 power n. So out of 2 power n cases, this is the total. If we subtract invalid, we will get valid. And what are the invalid cases? 2 power n minus k times k choose k over 2. And that is our answer. Okay. Now, there are a few more concepts you need to understand before you are ready to attempt this problem. You see, we are dealing with very large numbers, numbers like 10 power 6. So in other words, is it possible to store 2 power 10 power 6? No. Is it possible to calculate 10 power 6 factorial? No. So for each of these things, we will figure out methods. So for that, let me start with power under modulo. The easiest way to calculate power under modulo is, let's take an array. Let's keep this array size as n. And let's call n to be 20 now. Okay, for now. So we have 20 spaces like this. So the first space will fill with 1. Okay, from the second space onwards, we will simply multiply 2 times whatever is in the previous space, modulo m. Here m was 10 power 9 plus 7. Okay, so if we keep doing that, the whole array will be populated and we'll get the power under modulo. So if I then ask you what is 2 power n mod m, the answer is power array n. You will get the answer straight away, pre-computation, fairly easy stuff. Okay, great. Now, how do we calculate factorial under modulo? Do the same thing, create a factorial array. In 0th index store 1, in 1st index store 1, from second index onwards, you keep on multiplying this with the index number. So 1 times 2 is 2, 2 times 3 is 6, 6 times 4 is 24. If you do that, you'll run out of space because the number will get larger and larger. So at each stage, you will do modulo n. Does that make sense? So now if I ask you what is factorial of n or n factorial, all you have to do is, the answer is factorial array, just return the nth element. This will give you what? N factorial mod m. Again, very basic stuff. It will all be there in the code that I'll share in the link. The third is the most important concept. This is called modular multiplicative inverse. Why is this so important? Let me give you an example. So consider this case. If you have to do something like 3 mod 2 divided by something like, let us say, 7 mod 2. How do you calculate it? How do you calculate this? In case of modulo, you cannot directly do a division. If you do division, you'll get all sorts of erratic values. It doesn't work out. So for that, to do a division by 7 modulo 2, you have to first calculate what we understand as modular multiplicative inverse of 7. What is the modulo multiplicative inverse of 7? Let us call it as I. So what that means is 7 modulo multiplicative inverse of 7, and let's call it 11, by the way, to complicate the problem. So modulo multiplicative inverse 7, modular multiplicative inverse of 7 with respect to 11, what that means is 7 modulo 11 times I mod 11 is equal to 1 mod 11. Any I that satisfies this criteria, if it is, there is no proof that it will even exist, but if it is existent, we don't know if it will exist beforehand, but it will, because hint, this is a prime number, so it will exist. So if you are able to solve it, then I is said to be the modular multiplicative inverse. You can go to CP algos to figure out the algorithm to calculate modular multiplicative inverse of all numbers from 1 to n mod m. You will get it right there, but I'll just solve this for you very quickly. So here, if you take I is equal to 8, let's just calculate it. So 7 mod 11 multiplied by 8 mod 11 is equal to 56 mod 11. That is equal to 1 mod 11. Okay, so in other words, the modular multiplicative inverse of 7 mod 11 is 8 mod 11. So to solve our original problem now, if you are to do 3 mod 11 over 7 mod 11, because you can't divide by modulo, you'll convert it into MMI. So that will be 3 mod 11 multiplied by 8 mod 11 is equal to 24 mod 11. And the answer is, again, it's 3 mod 11. So, because 11 twos are 22, so it's 3 mod 11. So now you know how to calculate the modular multiplicative inverse. You don't actually, you have to go to CP algos. That is a very long discussion outside the scope of this short video. I don't want to introduce a lot of number theory into this series. So once I have modular multiplicative inverse, I'll calculate all the modular multiplicative inverse of 1 to n and store it in another array, which I'll call MMI. Okay. And for inverse factorial, I'll just create IF, another array, where I will take IF n is equal to IF of n minus 1 times whatever, MMI of n. What does that mean? For each element, I will 1 by 8 factorial is equal to 1 by 7 factorial times 1 by 8. I'm basically representing this in modulo language. So once I have the modular multiplicative inverse array, so this will have what? 1 by 7 factorial, this will have 1 by 8 factorial, this will have 1 by 9 factorial, not factorial, 1 by 7, 1 by 8, 1 by 9, etc. To get the inverse factorial array, what do I need to do? So I need to multiply all the elements up till here to get 1 by 7 factorial. and I need to multiply this with this component to get 1 by 8 factorial, and I need to multiply this with this component to get 1 by 9 factorial. So this will be my IF array. Once I have all of these, I can easily calculate my answer as, going back to the previous slide, so this will be power array n minus power array n minus k multiplied by factorial of k multiplied by inverse factorial of k over 2 multiplied by inverse factorial of q over 2. Why? Because the formula of NCR is n factorial over r factorial times n minus r factorial, implies k factorial by k by 2 factorial and k by 2 factorial. So the same thing I'm representing like this. So this will be easily solved. The code is available in the comment section, in the description. If you like this video, please subscribe. I'm trying to make these videos as quickly as possible so that my viewers are able to watch them today itself. So I'm making this in a great deal of hurry. So I apologize in advance if it feels a bit hurried, because it is a bit hurried. Thank you very much. Please hit the subscribe button for more such videos.